Hello, and welcome to Managing Metrics, a series of videos highlighting contact center metrics that matter to managers. This video focuses on two metrics, agent occupancy and utilization. We will define the metrics, discuss their importance, provide an approximate best practice range for these metrics, and mention their impacts on other KPIs and your operations in general. Note that the reason we're tackling these two metrics together is that they're often mixed up. Some systems even use the term occupancy for what we call utilization. We can't teach your old system new tricks, but we will indicate where the terminology has moved toward industry standardization. This video is brought to you by BenchmarkPortal, the source for contact center training, certification, benchmarking, and consulting. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit the like button. This helps us to continue providing free video training for contact center professionals like you. Okay, let's dig in. Now, while I like out-of-the-box thinking, I think the best way to explain occupancy and utilization is by using boxes. Let's draw a first box. This represents total paid time. Then let's draw another box inside the total paid time box. This represents occupied time. This is the time agents are actually in their places, logged onto the system, and available to take calls. The difference between total paid time and occupied time is time for paid breaks, time for training, time for meetings, etc. Agents are being paid, but they are not available for customer-facing work. Now let's draw a third box inside of the occupied time box. This is the time utilized box, or the time that agents are actually utilized helping customers. This includes talk time plus after-call work time, which might be cleaning up the customer record or sending the customer a link or a fax, etc. This inner box is the core time that the agent is actually doing customer-facing work. The difference between occupied time and utilized time is basically dead time that the agent spends waiting for the next call to arrive. If your center utilizes the same agents for calls and for emails, chat, etc., then all of these customer-facing activities are considered toward utilized time. Now, both occupancy and utilization are expressed as percentages, so we need to understand the numerator and the denominator. While there's no right way to do this, the calculations that are accepted for benchmarking purposes are the following. Occupancy is expressed as a percent of total paid time, that is, total time in place, plugged in, and available to serve customers, divided by total paid time. Utilization is expressed as a percent of occupied time, that is, total time actually helping customers as a percent of occupied time. By computing utilization this way, a spotlight is put on how well workforce management is filling up the available occupied time, how well it is forecasting and scheduling people to take calls during the available time. Since these are the two metrics that cause the most confusion, let's review with a couple of more slides. After all, one could argue that you want to know how much client-facing utilization you got for the overall money you paid for agents, that is, the inner utilized time box, as a percentage of the outer blue paid time box. And there is a certain logic here. However, the industry has coalesced around the definition of utilization as a percent of occupied time, precisely because it does highlight the effectiveness of the workforce management function in filling up available time. It is workforce management's ability to utilize occupied time that indicates how well they do their jobs of forecasting and scheduling. Centers with a really good workforce management function will typically save major amounts of money compared with their less efficient peers. Through benchmarking, you can actually compute the dollar value of your performance against your industry. There is a range of opinions on appropriate levels for occupancy and utilization. The idea is that you want to be as efficient as possible without stressing out your agents and causing them to leave. For occupancy, a normal maximum limit is shown here. The worker spends 8.5 hours at work, say 8 in the morning until 4:30 in the afternoon. 1.5 hour is unpaid lunch, and the other 8 hours are paid time. The 8 hours of paid time include 2 paid 15-minute breaks. So in this typical scenario, even without any other training, meetings, or other non-occupancy related activities, the very most you can have is 93.75% occupancy. Typically, we see actual occupancy rates for really good centers in the high 80% range, with the best centers for this metric in the 90%+ range. Utilization is also typically in the upper 80s for good centers with competent workforce management functions. However, I note that small centers and centers with a lot of discrete dedicated queues usually cannot be as efficient in utilization as very large centers, which can spread more calls over a larger agent population. Both occupancy and utilization are, of course, tied to budget and cost per call metrics. Utilization also interacts with calls per agent per hour, since the higher the utilization rate, the less time agents will be sitting, twiddling their thumbs, waiting for calls, and the more calls they will handle. Also, handle time, with its components of talk time and after-call work time, will also interact with utilization. We have more videos to help you hone your ability to manage with metrics. You can find links to these resources below. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, and feel free to leave comments or suggestions below. So that's it for our quick introduction to occupancy and utilization. Good luck optimizing your metrics in a healthy, balanced way. I'm Bruce Belfiore, and thank you for listening to this episode of Managing Metrics.